In this video, I'm going to show how you can use the Sigasi VHDL Editor as an editor for your Scineric Workspace firmware designs. I'm going to start off in Sigasi with the existing project that you can see at the moment. There's three files in this project, all assigned to libraries. What I'm going to do next is to create a Scineric Workspace project from this Sigasi project. To do that, I'm going to go into Scineric Workspace, click on the Add Design button, and then choose Create Design From folder. Important here is that you must select your source folder to be the directory where your Sigasi project is lying. The next important thing is that you must check search all folders. When you click on next, it will ask you some parameters for your design. We just can use defaults for this demonstration. And you will notice that the design has been created with all the files in that directory. Another thing you'll notice is that the VHDL libraries hasn't been assigned to these files as they are in the Sigasi project. That brings us to our next important step. If you look next to the name in your Scineric Workspace design, you will see a Sigasi icon. The Sigasi icon represents the Sigasi sync action. When you click on this action, Scineric Workspace will check if there's an existing Sigasi project in your design's working directory, and if there is, it will allow you to sync to that project or from that project. For our purposes, for what we're doing at the moment, we're going to sync from the Sigasi project. So when you click on Sync from my Sigasi project, you'll notice that the library mappings has been assigned from the Sigasi project. That demonstrated how you can create a Scineric Workspace design from a Sigasi project. If you want to do it the other way around, that is, start in Scineric Workspace and then create a Sigasi project, it's also possible. So to show that, I'm going to open the Scineric Workspace archived example, which is a firmware example. Okay, there that design has been opened now. So you will see this is a design with a few generated files and a bunch of source files. So again, we're going to go to the Sigasi sync action. In this case, the Sigasi sync action will see that there isn't the existing Sigasi project and it will create one for us. It will give us a confirmation that it was successful and it will give you information how you can open this project. I'm going to demonstrate that next. If you go back to Sigasi, you can go to File Import and then choose Existing Projects into Workspace. Again, select Root Directory must point to the directory of our Scineric Workspace design. And it will find the project. So we can click on Finish. Notice that the project has been added, and when you expand it, you will notice that all the library mappings have been assigned as they are in the Scineric Workspace project. So that demonstrates how you can go from the other way from a Scineric Workspace project and create the Sigasi project. When you're at this stage, you probably want to sync your designs. So the usage criteria here is that you can use the Scineric Workspace editing or management capabilities. That is, you can create packages from it, you can run your builds, and you can do advanced file management in Scineric Workspace. However, when you go to editing mode, when you're actually designing, you want to do it in Sigasi. So you want to be able to sync changes made from either side. So to demonstrate this, I'm going to start in Sigasi and I'm going to create a new file. Let's create this file under DFE firmware. Let's call this testme.vhdl, which is just an empty file. Notice that it's been added and it got the VHDL library of DFE firmware. If we go back to Scineric Workspace now, we can click on the Sigasi sync action and we want to sync from the Sigasi project again in this case. When we sync, we will notice that testme.vhdl has been added to DFE firmware library under HDL. So to demonstrate how I can change the category, let's change the category now. We will call this test library. Let's save our design. And now we want to sync to Sigasi. So we will click on the Sigasi sync button again, and we're going to say sync to my Sigasi project in this case. When you go back to Sigasi, you will notice that it doesn't update by default. The way to get around this is to close your project and to open it again. If you now go into the correct place, you will notice that the library mapping has been changed to test library. We reassign it to a new library. Let's call this Sigasi library. And now you can go back to Scineric Workspace, and again you can go through the Sigasi syncs action and you can sync from the Sigasi project. We'll now notice that the VHDL file was now assigned to the Sigasi library. The same sync capabilities notices when you add files or remove files, and it allows you to stay in sync. The last thing I want to show is how you can integrate the Sigasi text editor into Scineric Workspace. If you go to File Settings, Editing and External Options, or External Editors, it will show you that you can select text files to be opened with Sigasi, as shown on the screen. The Sigasi plugin in Scineric Workspace allows you to have the best of both worlds, the advanced VHDL editing capabilities of Sigasi to edit your designs, and the advanced file build and package management capabilities of Scineric Workspace.